This is a Lancair 360. It's classified as an experimental aircraft, which means it's an amateur-built or home-built aircraft. It has a 180 horsepower engine, although it's so light and aerodynamic, you can do over 200 knots with that engine. This one is owned by my friend and college roommate, Curtis Moldenhauer, so let's meet him and learn more about his aircraft.
My name is Curtis Moldenhauer. Currently, I'm a pilot for Mesa Airlines. I fly the CRJ-900. Flew with Bob years and years ago, and then I went off to Florida, did some flight instruction out there, ended up flying some King Airs out in Florida, did some skydiving out of the back of Pilatus. And before 9/11, flew freight out of Dallas, and 9/11 kind of put a hurt on the aviation industry for quite a few of us. So became an occupational therapist for quite a few years, and decided finally I was able to get back into flying. So I'm flying for Mesa Airlines. My dad flew for American Airlines. Aviation was always kind of in the family, and unfortunately, it's a terrible disease that you just can't seem to get rid of. I've had airplanes pretty much all my life. I mean, when I met you years ago back in college, I had old Cessna 175 back then, and it's really for just personal travel. The main reason we got this airplane here is we're heading from Wichita Falls down to Port Aransas, and the old Cessna 175 that I still have, it took 3 hours, 45 minutes. So looking to cut that time down, and this thing cut it down to under 2 hours. Look on barnstormers.com. I found it through one of their ads and called the gentleman up out that had it. He had it in Marna, Arizona. Made a deal with him on the phone and went out there, flew around with him one time, and he said, "It's all yours," and I brought it back. The biggest difference in between experimental and a certified aircraft is you're allowed a lot more latitude with the experimental aircraft. You can have some items that don't require what they call an STC. Like my autopilot is considered an experimental autopilot, but it is a lot more newer. I was running this when I was one of the beta testers for TrueTrack with their Gemini AP, and it was serial model number 3. So you get a lot, sometimes you can get a lot more current technology. Running the iPad in there, which is going through an eye level AW, which you couldn't put into a certified aircraft because it ties into the pedostatic system, and it gives me everything off of the iPad, and the iPad can actually talk to the autopilot and fly the airplane. It doesn't cost very much to fly it. I can get upwards of 25 miles a gallon at 230 miles an hour. It's comfortable enough once you get sitting in it. It's tight, but on the other side of it is you get, for being tight, you get to get there fast. I've flown it all the way from Las Vegas a couple times. I've flown to the Bahamas multiple times. Inexpensive to fly out there. Usually it's about $300 to fly to the Bahamas and back, and if I take my twin, it's about $3,000. It is a little bit smaller inside. I'm 6 foot, but I still have a little bit of room to move before my head hits the canopy. General specs, this is a Lancair 360 Mark 1. So it has the smaller tail, it has a shorter engine mount, which makes it a little bit more pitch sensitive. It's running an IO 360, and it puts out probably around 200 horsepower. I can get a cruise by myself, usually upwards, pretty close to 200 knots, 197 knots, and up at altitude, I can get the fuel burn down under 7 gallons an hour. The range on the airplane, it holds 43 gallons of gas, and if you get it up there, it can go a lot longer than my bladder can. It'll do more than 1,000 miles.
The flight plan for the day was to fly IFR from Dallas down to San Marcos for the Lancair owner's fly-in. I thought it was pretty interesting that he was using an iPad as his multifunction display.
And Tower, November 102, Mike, we're ready for departure up on runway 17.
Lance 102, Mike, Executive Tower, number 17, hold short, awaiting alpha release.
And we're hold short, 17, November 102, Mike.
This thing does not like to sit in taxi.
Yeah, it needs more airflow on it.
Lance 102 Mike, after departure, fly runway heading, wind 180 and 9er, runway 17, clear for takeoff.
Runway heading, runway 717, clear for takeoff, number 102, Mike.
Hi.
Clear left. All right. Wheel pumps, everything's on. Trims are set. Oh. Airspeed left.
Definitely smoothed out when the gear came up there.
Oh god, yeah.
Lancair 102 Mike, contact departure, have a good trip.
Contact departure, have a good one, number 402 Mike.
Bird?
That's 6,000. Hey, departure, number 402 Mike, with the climate through 3,000 for 2,000.
Yeah, 2 November, make sure we've got the weather on.
Thank you. 102 Mike, are you trying to call?
Affirmative, sir, we're climbing up through 1,500 for 2,000.
102 Mike, departure, ready to contact, climb and maintain 6,000.
6,000, number 102 Mike.
Gamma's at 861, contact approach 123.9er.
123.9er, Gamma's at 861.
Well, what's that?
It's amazing the difference, like in the avionics. I mean, just pricing because they're. Well, I mean, you got an iPad as your MFD. I mean, and it works just as well as anything else.
But oh yeah, yeah. We're actually, you know, we're flying off of this one.
I won't worry about that.
But I have a high level IW in here, so that pedostatic is real. And then of course the two-track autopilot. It works phenomenally well.
But I mean, that whole system, like the TruTac autopilot, would have been, you know, I mean, you know, that would cost 10 grand, you know, and then the MFD would cost you another 10 grand, you know.
Oh, yeah.
It's crazy how expensive that stuff can be. But being an experimental aircraft, you can do what you want.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you can definitely do what you want. And it is kind of nice that you can get, you can do a lot more stuff. And I've got everything that I need here, including if I want to, I've got synthetic vision. And I can move that up and down as I wish. So it really makes it kind of nice that I've got everything I need.
What software are you running on that iPad?
This is WingX Pro.
Yeah.
I also use Xavion, but WingX Pro is, it's half a dozen one another.
Number 102 Mike, can we get a left turn? I just don't feel like I'll do that from the cloud.
02 Mike, roger, and you could deviate to the left as necessary when able to fly heading 210. I don't pick up the cloud, sorry.
I understand that.
And number
102
Mike, we can't fly far.
Number 102 Mike, can't fly far as you see, and you proceed VFR to San Marcos.
Thank you,
Mike.
Number 102 Mike.
And 102 Mike, you want to fly forward over to the tower now?
We'll just go over to the tower here in a second.
102 Mike, at your discretion, contact San Marcos targeting.
Have a good one, November 102 Mike. San Marcos Tower, November 102 Mike, is it with you? Looks like we're about 20 miles up to the north end here, inbound.
November 102, Mike, semi standard, make straight in runway 13, and report a 4 mile final runway 13. We're into 1906, that's 3003.
3003, report 4 miles for 13.
Number
102, Mike.
Flying in the shade.
Yeah. You didn't have this,
That is a tablecloth.
What?
That's a tablecloth.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it's necessary in this airplane.
It is.
4 mile final, November 102 Mike.
November 102 Mike, runway 13 clear to land, wind 180 at 7.
13 clear to land, November 102 Mike. Clear to land.
Your ears pop a little when you put that down. I guess you can feel it open in the pressure hole there, I guess.
We got 3 green.
Best versus arm.
Yeah, right.
Blast
20. And we're identified. This is 13. Can you agree?
I'm 13.
They're small tires, so it's never a nice landing.
Yeah.
Well, we'll try it a couple times.
That's pretty smooth, though. It's not bad.
Lancair 102 Mike, if able, turn right. Next taxiway, taxiway Echo, contact San Marcos Ground 120.12.
Hey, we'll go over to ground here at Echo and 120.12. You have a good morning.
Overall, it was a very nice and fast flight down the 200 miles to San Marcos.
All right, Curtis. Thanks, sir.
No problem.
It's good to see you again. It's been a long time.
Good to see you. It has been.
We were roommates in college, so that's kind of a long time ago.
So either we'll find each other, we'll either find each other flying or
back
on
the
boat.
Water.
Yeah.
All right. Thanks, sir.
Have a good one. All be right. Careful.
Thank you so much for watching. Please check out one of our other videos, and this channel is funded by our patrons.